If you've been following my channel recently, you may have noticed I've been doing a lot of chiptune styled music. You may have also noticed I've become more involved in using the Commodore 64 and its SID chip, this guy. Well, to say the least, I've always loved chiptunes. I've always loved opening up a key gen and having a mod blast at me, or the sound of an old NES game. But one of the problems in achieving that sound is that, well, I'm not very good at trackers. I won't lie, when I open up Famitrack or LSDJ, my ADHD kicks in. It just makes me want to get right into the recording part. I've always had a small attention span, and when I have to edit my sounds, effects, filters, and edit everything on an ASCII note table before I can even start to lay down a song, I lose interest and then just shut it off. I've always wondered if there was a better way. I bought this synth called a Sandwich SID a few months ago, and that's what started this whole journey. I bought it because I thought that it would make getting those chiptune sounds a lot easier, especially the Commodore 64 ones, considering that's what it's emulating. But when it arrived, the synth only came with one of its sound chips, and it uses what's called a Swin SID, which is just a emulated version of the 6581 or 8580 MOS chip that's in the Commodore 64. So when we first plugged it in, the chip itself had been overfluxed and wasn't soldered properly, so it had a lot of noise coming out of its filters, and I just thought that something was completely wrong with it. This led me to go all the way to my dad's house and pick up my old Commodore 64 out of my childhood closet there. Well, this Commodore hadn't been touched in quite some time, probably more than 20 years. I didn't even know if it worked, but it was a shock. I just wanted to see if the chip would work in the Sandwich SID. I installed the SID chip, and of course it didn't work. This made me wonder if the entire system didn't work. Which, after plugging it in, that assumption was correct. The light didn't come on, no power, no nothing. So, to cut the story short, we spent a good month fabricating a new power supply, going through the whole system chip by chip, and just checking continuity, making sure everything worked in it. And after everything was said and done, we got it to boot. And after we got it up and running again, my interest in the actual hardware came back. I even started brushing up on my basic with the help of this guy. So what had happened is that the power supply on the Commodore at some point had either overvoltaged or shorted and taken out the SID chip with it. Now, we had ordered two more Swin SIDs for the Sandwich SID, and I'll get into that in another video of why I really didn't want to use it for doing what I'm trying to do. I record most of my music using Reason 10 and Native Instruments Machine. And the common thing between these is that I can always output the tracks as MIDI. And recently, I found a way to, at least with the Commodore, use my MIDI tracks to convert into a tracker format where I can output them as a SID file. And that is what I'm going to show you how to do today. For this to work, you're going to have what's called an SD to IEC. Essentially, what this device does is that it emulates the 1541 floppy drive from the Commodore 64. You can use an SD card, and then put your files onto it, and then run them as if they were a floppy drive. Before we start, you're going to need two programs. I have links to these in the description below, as well as a link to a free MIDI editor if you don't already have one. The first thing that you'll need to do is to download SID Wizard and extract it to a folder. I've chosen a folder directly on my C drive so that it's easier to get to with the command prompt. You'll see why in just a minute. Once you've extracted the files, move to the application folder, and then find the SWM convert program and the file above it. Copy those two files. Go back to the original directory on your C drive and then paste these files. For this example, I'm using MIDI editor and a SimCity 2000 MIDI. Once you have your MIDI prepared and saved, we'll move on to the first step. Once you have that saved, open up a command prompt. After you've opened up your command prompt, type in CD for change directory, and then go to your C drive. CD again back into the folder that you've created on your C drive. In this example, I used SID. After you've done that, type in the command swm convert and then the name of your MIDI file. It will automatically convert this to an SWM file that we can use in SID Wizard. Once your files are converted, go back to your application folder and open up the SID Wizard disk. And it ends with a .d64. If you have Directory Master installed, it should automatically open up. In Directory Master, you can see all the contents of our disk. Now we're going to go back to our original folder that we saved the SWM file into. We're going to drag that into this disk. Go ahead and save, and then open up WinVice. Once WinVice is open, go back to your application folder and then drag and drop the SID Wizard program that you just saved into WinVice. It should automatically open. When SID Wizard is open, you can press F8 to get to the menu. Once you're in the menu, you can go down and load song. You should be able to see your song here. Once the song is loaded, go ahead and press F1 to play. You can hear that no unique instruments are loaded, it just went to a default. I'm not going to go through how to do everything in SID Wizard. There are many tutorials out there already on YouTube. But an easy way to find instruments is just to go back and load song, and then find another song that already has some made. You can go through and then save each instrument that you like, and then open them up and then load them into your song. Here's a quick time lapse of me editing the song, and then this is what it sounds like after everything's done. Once you're happy with the way your song sounds, go ahead and save it. We're going to go back to Directory Master, and then we're going to open up the disk again. But this time we're also going to open up the SID Maker disk that is in the application folder alongside of it. You should be able to see the contents of both disks, and then you'll take the song that you've saved into the SID Master disk and drag it into the new disk for SID Maker. Most likely you'll have to save this as a new disk. Go ahead and open up the SID Maker disk that you just saved. You should see the song that you saved to it, and you should now be able to go through and convert this. Once your song file has been converted to SID, you can now go back to Directory Master, drag and drop that disk once more, and then pull out the SID file. This file will be saved as a SID sequence. So the last step before we can get it to run is we need to right click, rename, and edit out the sequence part from it. So it's just named .sid. We'll go ahead and we'll open up vsid in the WinVice folder and drag our SID over to it and test it to see if it works. And success, it works. Now let's put it on the SD card and see if it works on the actual Commodore. There you have it. We were able to take a MIDI, convert it to a SID, and play it on a Commodore 64. Now this is something that I've been trying to do for years and just noticed there wasn't a tutorial out there really explaining it in depth. So I figured I might make this so it would help someone else out there. Another thing is I'm not saying that I don't like trackers, it's just I really wanted an easier way to get my MIDI into a tracker that I've already done in Reason. So if you're really good at trackers, more props to you. It's just not something that has been easy for me to get used to. Another thing is the sandwich said, while it's a great synth, I feel like it's better used live. I haven't really been able to figure out how to program it with the sounds that I want, so you're kind of stuck with the presets. And as I learn more about it, I'm going to make a video and explain everything about it, but it just didn't work with the exact sounds I was trying to go for. Everything kind of felt stock, almost like an old Casio keyboard. It almost sounds too good. It doesn't sound chiptune-y enough to me. Anyway, I hope this video has helped some of you guys out if you've been looking for this or been searching around on forums for a while. If not, and you just enjoyed watching the video, feel free to click like and subscribe.